All right, match two, we're on the draw, and I finally have a Noose Constrictor hand. Like I said, I think it's pretty much the best card in the deck because it glues everything together, it makes your Orreries work. I also have Eldritch Evolution. All right. So we can play Noose Constrictor here. And I could set up a Haunted Dead next turn, discarding some cards into an Eldritch Evolution. Looks like we're just playing all blue-white all the time here. It's fine, though. The worst is if I get Reflector Maged right now, then I'm pretty much losing. If I get Reflector Maged, though, I think I still discard Haunted Dead. Yeah. Constrictor's fantastically holding back Smuggler's Copter, so that's always nice. I'm not going to play into Spellqueller, I'm just going to play Land Go. They didn't crack this, so they're almost assuredly to have Spellqueller. Or at least they can bluff it. Cracking it doesn't really do much other than draw an Inspector, so I think we just pass. I'm going to discard Haunted Dead, which can discard Swamp and Key. That is interesting. So they wanted to hold up the option viewing this for and Spellquelling. I still think they have Spellquellers, is what it's telling me. So I could discard this. I need to think about if I want to discard anything else, though. Like, the key is not particularly good, but I think we want the rest of our cards. I can get this Spellquellered and then try to eventually set up a Pariah. How are we not getting coptered? What's going on here? I guess they just went straight to combat. My assessment of the game seems to be a bit off. So I might actually just get Gitrog here instead. Or play Orrery. They're looking for land drops. I think if I draw, well, that makes it interesting because then this could get Pariah. If I play Orrery and I draw another card, next turn if I draw a land, I can evolution this away and then have Orrery set up. I can even evolution this away and Pariah. So I think I should still just play this. Land is just incredible next turn. This doesn't even have to resolve. In fact, I play this if it gets Spellquellered. If it gets Spellquellered, it's pretty bad. But it's not the end of the world, because then I at least have Ghirapur Orrery going. Slightly annoying. So one option is this could get a Noose Constrictor, and I could discard my hand. It's one option here. The other option is play Weaponcraft to try to set up for a flip next turn. But it's kind of nice if I do this and they don't have another Reflector Mage, because then the Noose Constrictor blocks the whole board. They've already played a Stasis Nair and a Reflector Mage. My alternative lines aren't fantastic. I think I'm just going to do this because I think another Spellcaller is more likely than anything else. I think we're just playing the same opponent, huh? Yeah. That's a little disappointing. Oh no, I'm playing someone else. Never mind. Just recognize the name. Sometimes in leagues, because of the way the pairings work, if there's not enough people playing at one moment, sometimes you can just re-queue into the exact same person, so I'm glad that didn't happen. Sometimes it does. Alright, Selfless Spirit. I think we just discard both. Yeah, that's absurd. So I can discard. I could just pass here. Haunted Dead can discard Haunted Dead and Pariah. I can cast Pariah. Then I can. I can just do some crazy things here. I certainly don't want to cast anything. And this threatens being a 6/6 right now. I also just might play a Spellqueller out. Just to go wide. Yep. Alright, so we should Haunted Dead, discarding Haunted Dead, and Pariah, and Madness Pariah. And I could untap. Get Eldritch Evolution. Get Eldritch Evolution this into Gitrog Monster. This can also just attack Gideon. If I turn this into Gitrog though, I can kind of just combo off. I think I should just draw a card. Now I can just play to the long game. I can eventually find another key because I have four of them. So if I take Gitrog here, I guess how many creatures would I have? If I got another Pariah, one, two, and I return Haunted Dead, that Haunted Dead is three creatures right now. So I don't have enough for a double flip, but I'm pretty close. Maybe I'll just take another Pariah. Might be better than Gitrog Monster. I think it is. Can't really attack though. I think I should return this now to threaten a flip at any moment's notice. Like, we can't actually clear their entire board, but we can get kind of close. Right now they would have seven creatures. And just play an Avacyn. And flip it of and Gideon. They'd just be left with Avacyn if I flipped both. This game's pretty sweet. Ooh, going for this line. Alright. playing Avacyn. And then they're just going to attack. Maybe I should flip a Pariah right now. Yeah, I probably should flip a Pariah in response. Doesn't seem like this is very good for my opponent, actually. Alright, just block. Okay. Don't really see what any of this accomplishes. So upkeep, I can scrap heap scrounger, do this. And sacrifice those, then I get to attack for 12 here. Yeah. Alright, yeah, I mean, the double Pariah flip was completely backbreaking. Nice. Alright, so I'm gonna go back to the same plan we had before. I think on the draw I like doing this. Alright. This is not the hand we want. This hand's fine. Swamp is probably good. I'm not sure it's good, but it lets us cast an Enthusiast. Right. We didn't get coptered for once, which is kind of nice. I'm gonna just play this. We're gonna run it into their spell queller. Ooh, they didn't have it. That's pretty sweet.